Okay, because there is lots going on shell, let's see what we have currently on master. So we tap on our super key, and we already see we still have the vertical workspaces. Exactly like it was before. But not exactly as before, the dash has now moved on the bottom. And moreover, the application grid has been transformed to an horizontal orientation. Basically, GNOME developers are moving parts from Shell 40 concept to master, bit by bit, brick by brick, patch by patch. And next I want to specially show you one of those patches, but only after our sponsor.
Stupid Coco, we don't have any sponsor.
Alexa, can you cry for us?
Boo-hoo! I mean, booyah!
And anyway, I want to show you these designs by Alan Day, that bring some visual changes on the Windows Picker overview. And probably the most significant change is that we now have these application icons. And it only took 10 years for Alan to create those. But we have some more things like the visual feedback on selected windows, that now the window animates instead of getting a border around it. There are a few more things, and fortunately we can see everything because Florian has written some patches. Just notice those aren't on master yet. And so, if we now enter the Windows overview, we have the application icons coming with a fading effect, and we also have the scaling effect on selected windows. But because the zoom animation also moves the neighbor windows, it feels like shopping from IKEA where everything is shaking and it's ready to break. And in general the look and feel isn't that great. Actually, so far Shell 40 reminds me Tenet. I watched it twice and I still didn't understand what the hell was happening.